Hey, my name is John Griffith, and I am a software engineer at SolidFire. I'm also a contributor to OpenStack, specifically the block storage service, Cinder. Today, I wanted to kind of go through real quick and talk about how you can use volume types and extra specs to set QoS on a volume when you're using SolidFire for your backend in Cinder. So there's a number of things we've already done. We've already set up our Grizzly install, and we've set up our SolidFire cluster and configured Cinder to use the SolidFire driver to point to our SolidFire cluster for the backend storage. So from there, now all we need to do is go over to a shell, and we've already installed the Python Cinder client, and we've already sourced our credentials as an admin user. It's important that you remember you're going to need admin privileges in order to create the type and the keys. So rather than type in my passwords and admin name, I'm going to go ahead and just use a creds file that has all that set. So the first thing we're going to do is we're just going to go ahead and simply do a type create, and we're going to call it demo type. So there we have a new volume type with a UUID and a name. The next thing that we need to do is we need to actually give it some sort of meaningful data. And that's where the extra specs keys come in, which are basically metadata that's assigned. Something to keep in mind is with Grizzly, the filter scheduler has been introduced, which makes a lot of intelligent decisions, or is capable of making intelligent decisions, based on volume types and, in particular, extra specs. Those extra specs can be things like volume backend names, capacity information, capabilities information, things like that. We'll go into that in another talk, but for now, we're just going to focus on what the SolidFire driver is using. So the reason I mentioned that is what we want to do is we want to give it what's called a scoped key. A scoped key is basically giving it a designator to tell the filter scheduler, hey, ignore this. Don't try and make capabilities decisions based on this information that I'm passing in. Just pass it through to the driver. And then what happens is the SolidFire driver can look at it, pick up those keys, and then make the decisions that it needs to make and make the settings that it needs to make using that information. So we're going to go ahead now, and we're just going to go ahead and create an extra spec key or keys. So type key, and we're going to give it the UID of that volume type we just created. And in this case, we're doing a set. And then we're going to do QoS colon, and that's the scoping that I talked about. And then the actual values that we're interested in are minimum IOPS, max IOPS, and burst IOPS. And what was there other? Okay, so now we have created our type and we've assigned some keys to it. We can take a look at the keys and verify that everything looks cool there. Oops. So there we go. That all looks fine. So now I'm just going to go ahead and I'm going to create a couple of volumes. I'm going to create one without using the volume type that we just created and show you the default QoS settings. And then also I'm going to create a second one with these settings. So we'll do a Cinder create. And I'm not going to give it a description. I'm just going to give it a simple name there. So you can see there's a volume there. I'm going to do a list. It's available. Everything went well. Now we'll do another one. Special. And we'll do type. And go back up to this UUID. And give another size 20. So you can see already here the volume type we specified. So that's a good sign. Do a list real quick. And you can see everything's available. Everything's set up and ready to go. Let's go over and take a look at the SolidFire UI and check out what it says the QoS settings are. Do a refresh here. And sure enough, there's our two volumes. One thing you can take a look at too, interesting. Notice that the volume name that we use on the SolidFire cluster also corresponds to the UUID of the volume from OpenStack or Cinder's perspective. It's kind of a nice little tool for an admin if you need to go into the cluster through the UI or some other form through the API or something like that and do some kind of operations. It's easy to make a correlation of what volumes on the cluster correspond to volumes inside of OpenStack. So that's a real quick rundown on how to use volume types and extra specs to set QoS if you're using SolidFire. I hope that was helpful. And if you have any questions, please feel free to give myself or anybody else at SolidFire a call. Also, you can always reach me on IRC. My handle is Jay Griffith, and thanks.